Hey, what's going on you guys? It's Acid Glow here. So we have some Quake 2 footage in the video and I want to talk about Twitch. Mainly my experience on Twitch. So I've been on YouTube for, 7 years. And I've never been into the whole Twitch thing. I don't live stream myself and I don't plan to yet. So I think for the past, almost 3 weeks, I've been watching a little bit more Twitch so I can get into the whole interactive thing that it has, because it's all live stream, so you can talk to the broadcaster and get involved in the chat and so on. So I've started to watch more Twitch channels and I've come across a few that I actually do like. Now, most of these channels I've actually started to follow are ones that stream older games, like old school stuff that I've seen back in the 90s, early 2000s. A few of them are like Call of Duty and so on. So here's the thing, I started to watch more Twitch so I can become more interactive in the chat, because I like talking to people and the whole thing with Twitch is kind of getting to me. It's actually a little bit fun. So I want to talk about my experience so far within the past 3 weeks about trying out Twitch and just, you know, seeing what it's all about. Because in the past, I wasn't really too much into Twitch because I had to be online at the same time as the broadcaster in order to watch these live streams. And I would only really watch them for fighting game tournaments. I wouldn't watch it for like other channels like Call of Duty and other fighting games. Mainly, I was into Twitch just to watch big fighting game tournaments, especially all the ones that were in the United States and the upcoming Evo tournament. So the last 3 weeks, I've been hopping on Twitch a little bit more and finding other channels that stream video games I like to watch as well. And it's weird, like, these channels are a little bit strange, like, not the majority, a few of them. Like, there's this one where this chick was streaming Call of Duty. Now, when they live stream, normally what you see is a huge window that is meant for the gaming footage and then a very small tiny window for the broadcaster's cam. But this was reversed. I hopped into this chick's stream for Call of Duty. The game window was super tiny and the cam window, or like her tit cam, let's call that, okay? Her tit cam was freaking full screen, the entire window. I'm like, are we here to see tits or are we here to see Call of Duty? I'm like, fuck, what the hell? And then pretty much this girl is wondering why the hell she gets pervs on her channel. I'm like, there's something wrong here, okay? And then she gets pissed off because this is what she's broadcasting, really. Her tits are pretty much plastered all over the fucking video. I'm like, okay, whatever, this is dumb. So I'm checking out another Call of Duty channel. And this dude is on YouTube, okay? So he's got a ton of subscribers, a lot of followers on Twitter. And man, I have never seen this guy on live stream before. Like, I know what he looks like personally, but the thing is, I've never watched a live stream to see what his interactions are when he plays Call of Duty. So I've seen a couple of his videos and the guy is going through some hard times and I've kind of felt bad for him, especially because of the situation he's in with YouTube and stuff. So I've never been one to bash on the guy. Like, the guy gets a lot of hate on his YouTube videos because of his weight problems and just the way he looks. And I've never been one to attack him on his YouTube videos about that stuff. So I decided to tune into his live stream today. And I was like, oh, this guy live streams. I didn't know that. So I went and I checked him out and it was a different experience than what I've seen on YouTube. Because when he does his YouTube videos, he does do like sobbing videos where he's all depressed and upset about stuff in his life and stuff on YouTube and all this stuff, whatever. But when I went to his live stream on Call of Duty, I expected maybe something a little bit more enthusiastic, something maybe better, because it looked like he just wasn't enjoying himself. He was playing League match and he was just getting so into the game and getting so frustrated and so mad that he wasn't doing well. And the weird thing is, like, he's got a lot of followers that want to play Call of Duty with him. But because this guy takes the game so fucking seriously, he worries so much about his KD, his win-loss ratio, his current rank on League and whatever. Because he worries about that nonsense so much, he never really gets to play with his fellow subscribers or his followers. When I saw the live stream and saw that he focused mainly on that stuff, I thought, this is someone you will not have fun playing with. And that's the first time I went to his live stream. And I'm comparing this to checking out some of his videos where he's got a different personality. And he's only playing with people on his live stream during league play, with people that he knows that are so-called really good, because he was saying, I'm not going to play with fans who are low ranks because then I can't work on getting my master rank or whatever the fuck it is. And I feel pretty bad for his followers who actually want to play with him and just have fun. And all he cares about is his rank and so on. And for him saying that he's not going to play with subscribers if you're a bad player or if you're not good, that's kind of mean to say, you know? And these are the people who actually bumped up your views for, you know, millions of views every month. And then this guy starts raging on his own teammates during league play. Like, really freaking raging. Complaining to his teammates, no one's covering me. No one's giving me backup. You guys aren't doing this. And the other guys, I can see they're not really responding back in the same tone of voice that he's using on them. So they're just trying to be a little bit more subtle in a way. So, like, this dude has got problems, like, really. Like, I knew he rages, but not to that extent when you have to take your anger on your teammates, you know, who are also your friends. And I don't see it as a way of typical COD rage. Like, this dude was, like, really getting pissed off. He really, really wants to win. And this is just online. This is not for money in some fucking championship. This is just online. Like, fuck, man. Really. And this guy only plays Call of Duty for his channel, and he just gets so frustrated, so bored and fed up with the game. And it just makes you wonder, you know, if you're only just playing one game all the time, yeah, you're going to get bored of it eventually. So my experience with that guy's live stream was really short-lived. I was there for a few minutes, and then I offered some advice saying, maybe you shouldn't focus on raging so much. Try to focus on your viewers. Try to be more interactive. Maybe that'll help, you know, and it'll actually help you get back up to your normal view count on YouTube. Because the guy lost 2 million views per month over the past, I think, 6 months. And he's basically been going downhill because it just seems like all he's really making in videos is just, like, sad, depressing videos. And he just wants everyone else to pick him up for him. And he just doesn't want to try to do things for himself. It's weird, you know. So after I offered him some advice, the guy timed me out on his channel, which is fine. I don't care. You can ban me for all you want. That's the first and last time I'll watch your live stream, because after that, I don't want to see it a second time. Fuck that. And after seeing how he treats his viewers and his friends on a live stream, really? And after the guy raged, he, like, threw his controller and his headset on the freaking ground and shut off the live stream. Didn't even thank 500 viewers for tuning in to watching him live stream. He didn't thank anyone. He just said, fuck this game, whatever. He got so mad at the match because he lost. Then he just shut everything off and left. That's it. Really, I mean, that kind of attitude really isn't good. And hopefully his viewers actually pick up on that. And that's something that you really shouldn't tolerate, you know. When you like someone's channel or their videos or their live stream and so on, you expect them to be friendly. And I've come across a lot of live streams that are actually really friendly and really interactive. They're nice people to talk to, and they respond to their fans. And this brings me to another thing. There are also those broadcasters that just put up a live stream and they don't interact with their fans at all. Really. That is really boring. I've like came across, I think, one or two of them that were like that. I was there for like a few minutes, and then I was like, all right, this is boring. I'm talking to myself, and the chat is pretty much dead too. Like, if I just want to watch someone play Call of Duty, I'll hit up YouTube for that. I'm not going to go to Twitch. The whole purpose of Twitch, I find, is for a more interactive experience. But I mean, hey, Wings of Redemption, you really gotta fucking change your attitude and stop fucking making sad, depressing videos and just work on your content. I know this is coming from someone who has a smaller channel, but I certainly don't talk to viewers in that manner, especially when you have 500 viewers live streaming with you and you have friends that are playing with you and then you just fucking rage on them like, oh fuck, man, like what the hell? So anyways, another thing, okay, channels that only let you chat if you sub to them, and this is a paid subscription. I'm like, what the fuck? There was one channel in the fighting game community that I used to watch a lot, and then when they changed it to sub to chat only, I was like, what the fuck? I gotta pay just to talk? Yeah, I mean, I can understand if maybe you want to use it as a means of cutting down on all the spam that happens during these tournaments, which is understandable, but I've watched this guy stream for a long time and he really does not get a lot of hate or spam compared to other channels that do fighting game tournament streams. Like overall, this dude was pretty cool. He's pretty averaged in terms of his personality, so he's a really nice guy to talk to and I've enjoyed his commentary. But when this guy went like sub to chat, I was like, fuck it, forget it. I'm not going to bother watching, really. And I think what's even worse than sub to chat is subscribed or paid subscriptions to view videos on Twitch. Like, what the fuck? When the hell did people even try to do pay-per-view on Twitch? I don't believe in that. I mean, you have ads running already, and that should be enough, but telling people that they need to pay for a subscription just to watch your fucking Marvel vs. Capcom 3 videos? No. And this very same channel that did that actually lost a lot of viewers when they did that. And it wasn't until, I think, a couple of months later, they decided to change it back to a normal channel. So, anyways, yeah, that is it. That is my experience on Twitch so far. It's pretty good, but every now and then, you run into assholes that just don't know what the fuck they're doing and they don't appreciate the viewers they have. So anyways, that's it. So if you guys have any experiences on Twitch, either good or bad, let me know. And I will see you guys later on. This is Acid Glow and I'm out.